In this recording, we'll cover the basics of how to navigate the Workday for iPad app. When you log into the Workday for iPad app, it will open to the home screen. From here, you can swipe left or right to scroll through the available worklets. To open a worklet, just tap an icon. Tap the back arrow to return to the previous screen. Another way to navigate the app is from the menu. Tap the button in the top left corner to expand the menu. All of the worklets are listed here and allow you to quickly get to the information you're looking for. To return to the home screen, just tap Home or tap in the middle of the screen. Another feature you'll notice on the home screen is the search feature. To search for an individual, just enter their name. Here you see three people who have John in their name, but only one is named John. Tap the arrow for a quick view about the individual, or tap the expand arrows to see John's complete profile. The expanded profile view displays an individual's contact information, experience and job information, personal notes that you've added, and anytime feedback from others in the organization. It's important to mention that personal notes can only be viewed by you, while anytime feedback is public information that everyone can see. Tap the plus sign to add a comment. Feedback allows you to share your experiences and thoughts about another individual with other members of your organization. Type in your comment and select a badge that represents the comment you made. Then tap Done. Your comment will now be listed under John's Anytime Feedback for everyone in the organization to view. Now that we've reviewed the basic navigation, let's take a brief look at some of the worklets, starting with the inbox. The inbox is your personal activity stream. It's where you'll receive actions and notifications. In this example, we only show approvals. But if other types of actions were assigned to you, you could apply a filter that could sort them by action type. The same filter feature is available for notifications. Once you approve, deny, or send back your approvals, you can see that your inbox tasks will return to zero. Now let's go to the directory. The organization swirl shows Ben's position in the department, the other members of that department, and the organization as a whole. We can see that Ben belongs to the property management department, and the manager of that department is Enrique Vasquez. The organization swirl also indicates the hierarchical structure of the organization. The property management group is under the facilities group, and so on up the organization structure. To look at a specific individual, tap on their photo to open their profile. When you're done, use the back arrow to get back to the previous screen. Now let's take a look at the time off worklet. The time off worklet displays your time off balances and time off details, as well as allows you to submit a request for time off. To request time off, simply tap the days you want to take off. If you tap too many days, simply tap the day again to deselect it. When you're done, tap the next Select Time Off button. Select the time off type, adjust the number of hours if necessary, or add a comment, and then tap Submit. You'll see the confirmation and the required next steps for approval by your manager. From the Enter Time worklet, you can enter your hours by tapping the plus sign for a specific day and entering a time block. You can see the breakdown of hours on the bottom of the screen. When you're ready, tap Submit This Week to send your hours for approval. When you're done using Workday, just tap Sign Out to end your session. This concludes the Navigating Workday for iPad recording.